And this is what it feels like.
What's going on, everybody? The Javiiurena podcast now sponsored by Fast Sports on Instagram. I'm giving a shout out. Shoot, look at the jersey behind me. If you want a basketball, soccer jersey, go get it. You name it, you will not regret it. Go check out their page for more details, right? Also, quick shout out to your Shunis on Instagram. Go check them out. He's doing great things out there. Shout out my boy. If you need to shoot clean, you need a spot lens, get a little stain off it. You want to get it. Show them the What's going on, everybody? Episode 18 of the Javiiurena podcast. I bring to you guys the one and only Ricardo Ramirez. What's up, Ricardo? How are you, man?
Chilling, man. How are you?
Good, too. Shoot, so brought you on here because you graduated 2014, right, high school?
2014? Damn, that's so long ago. 15.
Yeah. All right, so I know I want to get started off with you playing soccer. Like, that's back in the day. How did it all start about, like, playing soccer?
Well, I mean, you know, Trelawney, it's a big, like, soccer town. Yep. And, like, everyone just played soccer. It started off with, like TYSA. Ended at TYSA like everybody else. But high school soccer, I don't know. I just started playing soccer in TYSA. Then I went to, like traveling soccer. And then school and sports just seemed like the right fit. So I tried out, made it. And then the coaching staff was, like, super nice and friendly, and I think more than anything, they really like focus on like building character, you know.
Yep, I feel it. So sticking on that Pitman team real quick. So you played all 4 years, am I right?
Yeah. Okay. All 4 years.
So when did you get moved up to varsity?
I got moved up my sophomore year.
Sophomore year. Okay. So How was the experience like playing varsity those 3 years?
So the sophomore year, it was not our best year, but mm-hmm. it was a big learning curve for me just because everyone's, you know, older, more physical, completely different from JV. But then, so on my travel team, I had like Grant and Sean and Tristan and all them.
Yeah.
So then I played on their travel team, and that's where they were for varsity. So it was like a good click. So we started meshing really well. And then my junior year is when like probably like my best year in soccer that we had.
Okay. And your junior and senior year upperclass year, those are the years like where I feel like Pitman started elevating, right? Like getting more known in soccer, right?
Yeah, definitely. So when Pitman first opened up, they had like a really good soccer team where they made it to like the semifinals in like D1. And then my junior year was when we also made it to semifinals and we won the league. So that was nice. I was tired of losing to Turlock all the time.
So I feel like going on that Turlock rivalry, I feel like your first year you guys like beat them, there was a streak that went on. Like after the first time you guys beat them in a while, that's when like say my year. And then just up until like I forgot, like probably like 2 years ago was the first time they lost them in a while. Yeah. But, like there was a little streak going on there.
Yeah, I mean for the longest time I feel like Turlock high school soccer was like they were the soccer team, you know? And then there's so many good teams and programs in Central Valley and especially in Turlock where I feel like it was just a matter of time before Pitman got better also.
Yeah.
So now like you see like Turlock and Pitman both going to like section semifinals, quarterfinals consistently. Yeah. So that's great, especially like both of us being so close.
Oh yeah, definitely.
I mean, one day it's going to happen where they're both going to be in the final, you know?
It almost happened. Shoot. Didn't they play whenever you coached them, right? They played that year they were up, they didn't play in the playoffs, but they could have played in the final.
Yeah. We ended up getting disqualified by the same team by Jesuit, of course. Yeah, you know, private school.
So your senior year is was that the year you guys beat Modesto High?
Yeah. How was that season? So that year was not our best year. We were like not as disciplined, and I feel like we had a lot of travel players who like focus more on travel and put like high school soccer like in second. So, I mean, we did okay, like not as good as we like wish we could have done, but it was all right. I mean, we got like a really bad seed, like 9 or 10, like it was a lower seed.
Okay, yeah, that's
so
right.
Modesto was placed pretty high and we had an away game and I think it was either Galdames or Adolfo who ended up scoring that in that game and we won.
And that was, I remember that was an intense game. It's crazy because, like, it's Turok and Modesto right there, you know, like two teams going at it. And both were good teams, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's crazy. Like I said, like, all these, like, Central Valley teams are slowly, like, you know, building out, getting better.
For real. So, adding it all, like, your freshman through your senior year, how was the soccer experience at Pitman?
It was great. I mean, I had a blast. I had a fun time. And then, you know, I always knew that, like, for me personally, like, soccer was always kind of like a hobby, just kind of, you know, stay focused on school. And then, you know, if I have extra time, like,
yeah, I feel
enjoy
like
soccer. It was a good way to, like, stay healthy. But I never, like, saw, like, anything past that with it.
Okay.
So by the time college came, it was, like, you know, hitting the books.
Yeah, I did. Feel like, so by the time college came, like you said, like, you already knew it was only in high school soccer. That was it as a hobby, right?
Yeah. So thankfully, like, I was able to, like, graduate from UC Merced in, like, 3 years.
Okay.
So I was, like, loading on classes, like, taking, like, 20, 22 units, because financially it just made more sense, because over during the semester, there's no cap limit to how many units you can take, and you still pay the same amount.
Okay, for
so
sure.
So I did that. I overloaded on units. I took, like, two summer courses, and then I was able to, like, take, like, a year, like, not off, but, like, a year to, like, do research on campus.
Yeah.
So that's what I did on my year off.
Okay, for sure. So as you say, you went to UC Merced, like, did your senior year, at, like, what point in time did you know you were going to UC Merced?
I always knew, like, financially, like, you know, coming to Central Valley again, we're not the most privileged people. So usually it makes more sense to just stay local.
Mm-hmm.
And so I applied only to MJC, Merced JC, Stanislaus, and then my number one pick would have been UC Merced.
Mm-hmm.
So once I heard back from UC Merced, I'm like, cool, that's where I'm going.
You're like, definitely.
But again, I did not like live on campus. I definitely had a commute, so that had its sacrifices.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Especially when I had like 7 a.m. classes. Like, man, I have to be up by like 6.
For real. Hey, but it was all worth it in the end, you know what I mean?
Yep. Hopefully. I don't know yet, but
okay, yep. So like, your time at UC Merced, like, how was that time there, like, commuting there and everything, like, how was it there?
Right. So my time at UC Merced was great. I think it's a really good school, and it really focuses on giving back once again to the Central Valley. And it has, like, the majority of the school is Hispanic.
Okay.
So they really cater to that population, which I really appreciate. When I was there, the school was really, really small. Like, you knew everybody on campus because there was only one street. So when you go up the street, you see the same people. Coming down the street, you see the same people. Or you'll have several classes with the same people over and over and over. And even if you don't know their name, you know them as, like, that other student from that one class.
Yeah, okay.
So, like, it was very friendly. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So they're by using the time, though. I was going to say, did you get involved in any programs there or stuff like that?
No. I actually did not. I considered joining, like, a medical fraternity and stuff like that.
Yeah,
but like, the reason I didn't was because the way I saw the fraternities were, like, they're supposed to, like, expose you to these, like, opportunities to, like, get that CV and that resume, right? But, like, at the time, I was already working at the hospital. And then I was already coaching for Pitman. So I'm like, I don't see the point in paying money to join a fraternity where it's not going to really add much more than I already have.
Yeah, like, that much benefit, you know?
Yeah.
So you spoke on coaching Pitman. How did it all come all about? Like, I know.
Oh, my God.
Games, like, how that, like, did someone contact you, or, like, did you contact them?
It was actually a really funny story. So, you know how, like, the TYSA, like, the adult league opened up?
Yeah.
So, like, I showed up there to coach. And then, I was actually playing for the adult league. And then I was coaching a younger team. And I ran into Coach Mercado.
Okay.
And we had, like, a small conversation. Then he's like, oh, like, what are you up to? And I told him that I was coaching. And he said, oh, man, I didn't know you were, like, interested in coaching. like, I would have hit you up.
Yeah.
So then I'm like, well, I'm still interested in, like, helping out. If you have, like, a good contact, I'll just show up and see if they need any help.
Yeah.
So then Coach Hofstein was the head coach, and they had Coach Memo. So I just showed up, and then I just volunteered the first season. And then we got, like, second place again to Turlock.
Yep.
And then after that, they said, like, hey, do you want to come back? And I said, sure. So then they put me on, like, payroll. I got, like, maybe, like, $500 or something like that. So, like, it's definitely not for the money.
Yeah, it's just something, though, you know what I mean? Yep.
Yeah, but, I mean, you get to play, like, some role in, like, influencing, like, these kids, you know?
Exactly.
And I think that made it worth it. I enjoyed it. And, like, let me relieve stress, but, like, definitely not for the money.
Yeah.
I mean, when I was coaching, like, the weekends were the ones that were horrible.
Oh.
So during the week, like, Monday through, like, Thursday, I would usually just go to school. And then, like, Thursday afternoon, I would go home. I would sleep, like, 30 minutes. Then I would go coach, you know, like, 2 to, like, 4 or something like that. And then I would eat, take a nap, and then I worked the graveyard shift. So I would work from 7 p.m. to 7 a.m.
So you were all over the place.
Yeah. So then Friday, I would do the same thing. And then Saturday, like, I was, like, dead. Like, yeah. I don't remember going out any, like, Saturday, Sunday. Like, it was horrible.
For sure. So, let's see. You bring up the – you coached 2 years, right? Or three? Two years, right?
I want to say two.
Two, okay.
I
want to say two,
yeah. I couldn't do the third year. Because I had gotten accepted to med school.
Okay.
So I had to leave, like, very late December of 2019.
Yep.
So I couldn't commit the whole season. So yeah. I'm like, I can't.
So your first year was it the Stan game where you guys had lost, right? I believe.
I don't remember.
And Turlock won CCC? Was that year or was the year after probably?
That was probably my first year, yeah, because my second year we won it.
Because the second year you guys went the final game against Pitman and Turlock at Pitman, right?
For the league? But so I think what happened was the first year that I was coaching, Turlock beat us at Stan and they ended up getting championship, right? But then the second year, like, we played them again, but I think we had already, like, guaranteed the title. So it was
It was just right there, like, as bragging rights game type of, you know?
Yeah. Just like bragging rights.
So let's go on the first year real quick. So that feel like that year, yes, you guys had a great team and all, but you guys still, like, learning. Like, it sucks for those seniors, you know, that to go out like that. But in the end, though, like, that for the next year's group, like, I feel like they had, like, gained chemistry, gained confidence, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And then we also had, like,
two of the next year's victory.
Yeah, absolutely. And then, I mean, we were missing players. I think, like Ricardo would have actually, like, really helped us out.
ACL, right? ACL injury.
Yeah, I think he ended up going still to Merced, and he got, like, therapy for it, and I think he ended up playing. So I actually haven't caught up with him, but I think he would have been, like, a good addition.
Oh, definitely.
But it also made room for, like, other players to, like, you know, prove themselves and, like, step up, and they had their chance. So, like I said, it was a good framework and a good meshing session for the season to follow.
For sure. So overall, coaching was a good experience for you there?
Oh, yeah. I would do it again.
Definitely. It seemed fun. Then after that, though, like you said about medical school, like, tell us a bit about that. Like, you told me you're in the Caribbean now. How'd that all, like, come about for you?
Man, so I took a year off just so I could build my resume. And during that year off, I coached. I worked in the hospital in the ER. I did scribing for a little bit, and then I did – I was a tech there. So and then at the same time, I was doing, like, research at UC Merced with a professor, you know, on, like, cancer cells. And then, so once I had, like, all that lined up, I'm like, okay, I feel like my application's, like, good enough now. And I applied to, like, all the Caribbean schools because they accept you, like, right away.
Okay.
So where on the U.S., it's, like, a one-year wait before you even hear, like, yes or no. So I applied. I heard back from, like, two schools, like, within, like, a week or two, which was great. But I hadn't heard back from my number one school, which is the one I'm at right now. And then when I heard back from them, it's a freaking roller coaster, man. Because there's a small island next to us. It's called Ceiba. And they were the ones where, like, they had a phone interview. And then I applied to Ross, and they had me go to Sacramento. So I interviewed at Sacramento. That went well. and then they accepted me. And then here I applied and we had a FaceTime interview. And then I heard back from here before I had heard back from St. George at all, but I wanted to go here. So I just canceled St. George.
Yeah. Okay. So exactly where are you at right now? The Caribbean, like you said, right?
Yeah. So the island is St. Martin.
St. Martin.
And it's like a colony sort of, like half of it belongs to the Dutch and then half of it belongs to the French. But it's like a big touristy area, actually. Like it's so diverse over here. Like
I bet you. Yeah.
Like you think like Sherlock's diverse? You come over here and you're like you're hearing like four different languages in like one day.
Yeah, that's crazy. So it's like it just looks like the sense that's kind of here in Sherlock. It's like I'm sure like everyone's at one point you'll know a lot of people, right? But then you move there. When you moved there, did you know anybody at all, or you just went there to like go there?
Obviously. So I came here with one of my buddies from high school, also from Pitman. His name's Sino.
Okay.
So we just said, yeah, let's do it. We got accepted here and we like booked our apartment and everything. We had not seen the actual apartment. We just put the down deposit and we're like, yeah. And then we flew in here. I was on a plane like New Year's Eve, when it hit 12 on New Year's, I was on a plane over, I forgot where. And then we didn't even know like there's no signal when you get off the airport.
Yeah.
So we just we're like, I don't even know where we're supposed to go. So we just find a taxi. We're like, yeah, can we go to this school? And then they're like, oh yeah, no problem. We do it all the time. So it's like, okay, cool. And we show up there and we're like, okay, where's the apartments that we're supposed to go to? So we ended up just like asking people. We find our keys, we find our apartment, and then we just go and the place isn't bad. We have no Wi-Fi yet, so we had to go to campus to get Wi-Fi. But yeah, it was quite a trip. It's quite an experience, but it wasn't bad. I mean,
so just basically making your way there, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, once you talk to people, everyone here is like, so this island's considered, like its nickname is the Friendly Island.
Okay.
Because like everyone is friendly, but they just have like different manners and you just have to get like used to it. The only thing that I don't like about it is there's this thing called island time where in the US, like if a place says they open at 7, they open at 7.
Yeah.
Here it's like they open at 7, 7:15, 7:45. Like it's like everything's slower.
Yeah.
So
just some things to get used to. More time to progress, right?
Yeah. But I mean, once you get like once school starts, it's really you're basically like locked up. Just
there. Oh yeah, definitely yeah. Cause like I forgot it was a while back. Whenever you post on your IG stories, like I would see like the Caribbean, like your pic of what you're doing. You know, I'm like, oh, I wonder where he's at. I thought like you're on vacation, but that's where you go to school. I'm like,
don't get fooled.
No, yeah, it's dope though. You know what I mean?
I'm like, yeah, behind the camera, there's probably a book somewhere.
So as you were in high school, or even UC Merced, so what's your major?
My major was in biology.
Biology? Okay. So was this well, at one point, what was your dream, college or medical school to go to?
So my dream college and my dream medical school were UC Davis.
Okay.
But just, I couldn't afford to go there as undergrad. And then I didn't even apply for it as for medical school.
For sure. So, but in the end though, are you having the time you arrived there?
I mean, it's fun. I mean, met so many people. Like the thing is you have it's a small circle in Turlock, right? Yeah. And then you go to college and it gets bigger.
Yep.
And it's okay, everyone's from California. They might be LA and you have a couple stragglers from other people, right? Other states. And then you get here and it's you have people from Thailand, you have people from Canada, from New York, from Mississippi, from Louisiana, California. It's literally all over the world. So that's really, really neat. And that's something that I don't think I would have experienced going to a US school. And it really exposes you to so many different cultures.
Yep, definitely. So in the end, I'll be out of your college experience, what's your biggest lesson that you've learned from education or even life?
I think if I could go back and change anything, I think I would enjoy it a little bit more.
Okay.
Especially high school, just enjoy high school, get good grades, but at the end, enjoy it, make it memorable, have fun. don't get pressured by the grades. I mean, don't fail, obviously. Don't get C's, but like B's, do your best. B's, A's, you'll be fine. College, enjoy the experience. You'll be fine. Because once, I mean, it's a whole different ballgame like in med school. Like, I think one of our lectures was basically, no, maybe like in a week. In a week, I'd say I went through everything that I had learned in undergrad.
Okay.
Ooh. So they want you to fucking like know it like.
Yeah, I feel it, yeah.
Like quick.
Yep. No, I get what you're saying though, because in high school, me, I wasn't like the best student. I didn't make grades certain years. Right. But then once I got to college, like you're paying for that, you know, you have to set your game up. Definitely. So, like you said though, yes, pass in high school, but college, they expect the best out of you. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. And honestly, like med school is not hard. Like the material is not hard. It's just a lot at once, you know? Yeah, like as long as you have like a good work ethic, like anybody can really do it. Like I don't consider myself like a genius or anything, but like I have like some work ethic where it makes up for it, you know?
Okay.
And then there's some people that are geniuses and they study like 1 week and they understand everything and they get A's.
Yep.
So, I mean, good for them, but some people just like, if you have a work ethic, you can do it.
Yeah.
And then the other thing I say I learned is that knowing what you know, like in school and stuff, like it's obviously good. Don't get me wrong. But like there's another side to it where there's also like a who are you as a person, you know?
Yeah.
Like you can know your things, but if you're an asshole, no one's going to like you.
Exactly.
You know, like you need to make those relationships because at the end of the day, having those contacts matters so much, especially like in the professional careers, like further on.
Which is why, like you said, like in Turlock, small circle, but then over there you expanded, you know, it's always good knowing more people.
Yeah.
You
know? Yeah. Yeah. So like at the end of the day, I'd say like, I want to like, yes, have these experiences and like get exposed more and then eventually take all this knowledge and bring it back to like, you know, Turlock, like my hometown, you know, like, honestly, I love Turlock. I miss it, especially like being over here and like, you don't see anyone that, you know, it's like, you kind of just miss the comfort of home, you know?
It's all about the grind though, you know?
Yeah. Definitely doesn't stop.
For sure. So as you bring up like all this stuff we talked about, what's your overall goal that you want to get out of all this?
Like from school or like,
from school,
career? Well, I want to pay off my debt. That'd be a good start.
Yep.
I mean, it's expensive, man. I'm not going to lie. Like, so, I mean, you have high school's free, right? For us, it's free. And then you go to like undergrad and it's a couple thousand dollars every semester. So you end up leaving with like maybe what, 30 grand or 50 grand in debt around, give or take, right? It could be significantly less, which it was for me. And then you come out here and it's like, yeah, we expect you to pay like 25,000 three times a year for 4 years. Yep. So it's like, you're like $300,000 in debt approximately. So after that, then you start making like, then you go to your residency and they'll pay you like 30 to 40,000 for 3 years. And then you're like an actual physician, like you can work by yourself.
Yep.
So then you start making like physician money, but at first you have like all those loans to pay off. And then those loans, I think their interest rate is like ridiculous. It's like 6% to like 7%, which is like horrible. Like it really like packs a punch. But thankfully right now with like COVID going on, I think they postponed like any interest rate accumulation till like September of this year. So that's nice.
So you brought up COVID though, like over there in the Caribbean, how I know in the whole world going through the pandemic, but how has COVID affected where you're at right now?
Right. So when COVID hit, like there was a big scare, right? Like no one really knew what was going to happen. Yeah. And people were like talking about like a 10% like death rate, which was way off.
Yeah.
I mean, if you were like asking people that like work in the field, like they were only testing people that showed any symptoms.
Mm-hmm.
That's why the number was so high. And then that number started decreasing. But here on the island, what happened was they shut down the airport and school. They said, everyone like go home if you want. You don't have to stay here. Everything that's in person is canceled. And then like you know how, like, in Sherlock, when they canceled stuff, like, you couldn't, like, you could still go to, like, drive-thru and stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
Here, there's no drive-thru.
Nothing, like, right? Nothing.
Yeah, no, like, the restaurants were closed, like, closed. The grocery stores would get closed. Like, they were closed for, like, a week or two. So it's, like, you just had to, like, make the best of it. And honestly, like, it sounds horrible, but everyone was fine. No one, like, really struggled with it. They had, like, an alcohol ban for, like, a week, and then they brought it back. And then, what else? Now, like, we still have to wear, like, face masks and stuff like that. And then when they decided to bring everything back in person, the school said, hey, we need everyone to come back by this date, officially. Like, we started getting cases going up again.
Okay.
But at first, I think we had, like, 16 positive cases for, like, a year. So, like, it was really good. But then, like, once they opened the airports again, like, that number just kept on going to, like, 100 and up and up and up. Yeah. But, I mean, a lot of the students here did go home. And I think there was maybe, like, 30 to 50 of us that stayed. So, like, people that I probably would not have talked to.
Yeah.
Like, we became, like, really, really close. Because, I mean, we were all that was left here.
Yeah. So, okay. So, only a certain amount of you guys stayed then.
Yeah. I just knew that, like, going back home, like, I wouldn't be able to study the same, like, you know.
You have to be there.
You know how parents are, you know? Yeah, like, hey, can you, like, take care of your brother for a little bit? Like, do you need anything?
For real. No, I feel
just, like, little things that, like, they do to be nice and stuff, but it's still a distraction, and I just couldn't afford doing that.
And you had to stay focused, right?
Yeah. And I was also afraid that, like, the school would want us back, like, the next day or something.
Oh, yeah, I feel you, yeah. And how long has it been, though, since, like, people went back? How long has it been since the beginning?
No, they came. So we shut down around, like, March.
Okay.
Of 20, like, I think it was March 18th of, like, 2020.
So nearly a four-year then, right?
Yeah. So they were gone for, like, a full year, and it wasn't until January 3rd that they, like, said everyone has to be back.
Okay.
But, yeah.
Okay, for sure.
The funny thing is, some people that were living here on the apartments, they thought that they were going to go home for, like, 2 weeks. So they didn't, like, pack their apartment up or anything.
Oh, okay.
So then, like, they were, like, struggling to find people to, like, go pack their stuff and send it back, or, like, have it, like, stored at our house and stuff like that. I'm like, dude.
Yep.
Like, honestly, what do you really think?
For real, so they thought 2 weeks compared to nearly a whole year. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Hey, we ended, like, they did give us all their food because it was going to go bad. They're like, take all the food. So I was like, hey.
Hey, there's some food right there, you know?
Hey, stores are closed. I'll take any food.
For real. All right, so now let's leap back to soccer real quick. So I know you brought up the TYSA, the adult league too. So how did you feel whenever, like, that all came about? Like, you're like, our age gets to play again.
I love it. You know? I love it. Because, I mean, I think we were, like, growing up, like, it was like TYSA was the shit.
Yep.
And then when they opened up the adult league, like, I'm so happy that Elijah, like, took charge of that and, like, did his best and brought this all together, because I think everybody enjoys it.
Yeah.
And, like, no one's there to, like, hurt anybody. It's just a bunch of old, like, guys that used to kick it together.
Exactly.
And we're not trying to hurt anybody. Like, we're all friends. We all know each other in some way. So it was fun to, like, play with them, say, hey, how's it going? And it's very healthy, you know.
Yep.
There's no, like, alcohol, like, in, like, other Sunday leagues. Like, people aren't drinking on the sidelines. So it's a very, like, good environment. And then, like, along with that, I love what, like, Academica is doing, you know, with their whole, like, soccer program and all that.
And there's even, like, new teams growing in the county, like, I don't know if you heard of Cruisers FC.
No, I haven't. Tell me about
it. They're a new team right here from Odessa, but they play at the new field in Turlock right here off of Linwood. By the cemetery, they made a new field.
Really? Is it turf or is it real grass?
It's real grass, but it's a super. That's the only field I know that they could play on.
Dang, because when I go back, everything's gonna be so different. I mean, I heard there's a Dutch Bros there. What's up with that?
Cool. Yeah, there's a new Dutch Bros by let's see, there's Domino's too right there by Sun State, literally across Sun State.
Yeah, and then there's also what is it? A Popeyes now?
Popeyes too, off of it's more downtown, my like 99 cent store.
And man, it seems like they waited for me to leave and then I got all this.
They're like, oh, we'll wait till Ricardo comes back, you know what I mean?
Yeah, specifically him.
For no, but they end up like, I feel like the TYC, like there's a competition level there, you know, like it's good though. Like,
yeah,
you,
yeah,
you're competing against your friends, you know.
Yeah, you know what I would actually like to see? I would like to see like a soccer academy school, you know?
I feel
like have Academica have like a soccer school, like
oh, okay, I get
we
you.
Focus on like, come to us, like if it was a regular school, we'll teach you like math, science, all this stuff, and we will focus on soccer and like, you know, build you up and have that be like their academy.
That's
like a full on academy.
Because like other schools like in Sacramento, like Jesuit probably, and then there's those top notch schools, they focus on that certain sport. Yeah, these two subject like math, science, all that. But they grow and that's how they gain all that chemistry, you know?
I mean, if you like, I got curious at like coaching, right? And I'm like, so I wonder like how much these kids are like paying. And I'm like, wow. So they were paying like, I think it was like close to like $15,000 for tuition in high school. Like that's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm like, the school that they lost to, I think they were like from LA or something, like for state or something like that. They're paying like $25,000.
So Jesuit and the LA team?
Yeah, so Jesuit was, they pay like around $15,000. Yeah. And then that other private school, I think it's from LA or like the Bay Area.
Yeah.
They're paying like $25,000. And like, I'm like, you know what? Us being in a public school, paying no money, just getting a bunch of kids together to play. Like, yo, you guys are not $15,000 better.
I know, for real, yeah. And to make it like a close, like not a close game, but like just, if they're paying $15, you should like,
they should be winning it every year.
Yeah, exactly. And all that for $1,500 down the drain?
Yeah, for real.
But, okay, so now everyone listens to music. So what are your top favorite artists to listen to?
Oh, man, I listen to everything. Right. Like, I listen to country and I listen to rap. I listen to everything. But I think right now I've really been listening to Mild Orange.
Okay.
It's just like a good steady band, so that's kind of what I focus on. It depends where I'm at too, right? I mean,
sure, yeah,
like if I'm hanging out or if I'm like going to the club, like different music.
Yep, I feel it. So you're more like a I listen to everything type, you know, like no really picky, you know, people are picky about the music.
No, I think a lot of people, like when people share their music, I feel like it really shares like something like personal about them. So I just try and enjoy it, especially like whoever made it, you know?
No, yeah, for sure.
Like they put a lot of effort. So there has to be something important to them to bring out all these like songs.
That's how it is though. So who's your favorite soccer player growing up to watch?
Messi.
Don't say Messi. Nah. Great player. But I'm a Ronaldo guy. You know what I mean?
I appreciate Ronaldo because he's like a fine-tuned machine, like he puts in work, but I think Messi's just like more natural.
I feel it. No, but growing growing up though, I completely just despised Messi because like I'm Ronaldo fan, you know. I just didn't like, I didn't care about him. But then as I entered like my later stages, like when I was like 18, 19, that's when I started to realize, I'm like, all right, I need to start respecting this guy, you know. And then I just feel like they're like, just respect both of them, and because we're not going to see anybody like those two, you know.
Yo, it's crazy. It's gonna be Messi crazy Ronaldo. When they leave.
Exactly. Like they got Mbappe coming, Haaland, but they're not gonna be Messi, Ronaldo.
It's crazy that I'm happy to say that like I saw them play against each other. You know, that'll be hell of a story.
Yep.
And then like I'm not even a big Barca fan. I like Barca a lot when they had like Ronaldo and all that, but I mean Ronaldinho and all that. But like I'm not really like a Barcelona fan. I'm more of a Messi fan. Okay. So when he leaves, like I'm kind of done with Barca.
Yep.
My actual team's Man U.
Man, what if he goes to the opposite team of that?
Yo, I might have to cry.
It's all about.
Like, I remember when. I remember when he said when rumors were coming up he was gonna leave Barcelona. I'm like, dang, that sucks. Yep. And then there was rumors that he might go to like Man City, and I'm like, no, you can't do that, man.
So what happens if that does happen? Are you gonna hop the? Hop the United
train? No, I have to hate Man City. I hate Chelsea more though. I don't like Chelsea.
Okay, for sure. But I also heard this rumor, like if City signed Messi, what if Ronaldo jumped back to United?
Yo, that'd be lit.
That would be like to relive that ever, you know?
Ooh, yeah.
That'd be cool. We'll see though.
That would be cool.
I'm gonna tell.
It's a lot of money in play.
I'm gonna ask you now, but is there anyone you like to see on the podcast? But before you answer that, though, help me out to this person, or even like could be anybody.
I'm trying to see. I saw you did Eddie already, huh?
Yeah.
That's cool. I don't know.
Hey, you know who I was low key trying to get in contact though?
Who?
Ricardo.
Oh, that'd be so much fun.
Yep. But I don't know if he's, and then even Coach Sergi, but I know they're busy and all, you know what I mean?
I think you start off with Coach Sergi and then and then have him like recommend you to Mercado, you know?
Yep, I feel it.
That'd be fun. That'd be really, really fun.
Do you have any like contact to get in contact with them?
I don't have Sergi's now.
Okay.
But I'm sure like if you go like on like anything from like UC Merced I think he's coaching like Merced JC College. Mm-hmm. Or like through Academica, I'm sure you could find his email in there.
Yep. Okay. So just email.
If not, just go to like an Academica game and you'll run into him, you know?
Yep, definitely.
And then say, hey, like I know like a lot of your players or whatever. I mean, you know Felipe and Ramirez and all that, you know, so I'm sure he's doing it. I'm sure he's more than willing to be like expressive about what he feels about soccer and all that.
Yeah, definitely.
Be a good story too.
Yep. Is there any that you want to see though? Not just those two.
Dang, I'd have to think about that. You know who I would like to see that would be really interesting, which is like way, way out there. It's like I would like to see Elon Musk.
Yeah?
No, just kidding. No, you know the guy who opened up Dust Bowl?
No. Who is it?
So he lives in, I think he lives in Turlock.
Okay.
But I don't even know his name, but I'm sure like if somehow you got him on your podcast, I feel like that'd be really cool.
Yep.
Or like getting all these like little like Turlock like own like businesses.
Okay.
Like talk to the owners and just be like, hey, like what made you want to do this?
No, I'll definitely look into that. You know what I mean? That'd be
I mean, they make money.
Expanding it too, like
and yeah, it takes work to like get it going. So I'm sure they'd have like some like really good stories.
Yep, for sure. So to end things off, is there any questions you have for me?
What are you up to, man?
What am I up to? Shoot, right now.
Yeah. After high school, what are you up to?
My final year at MJC finally. I took a while, you know.
Cool.
But communications major.
Cool.
I'm gonna most likely transfer to Stan State. But at the moment, like, I'm really focusing on fitness right now. Fitness, because when we last played for TYSA, like, I feel like that was the best shift of my life. I was going to go into playing for MJC.
Yeah, it feels good to be healthy.
Definitely. But then, COVID, I know I'm not using an excuse, but, like, it definitely did make me, like, slack off a bit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's easy, especially with, like, the gym being closed and wearing a face mask and whatnot.
But now I'm just focusing on not getting where I was, but, like, bettering myself. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's perfect. I mean... Yep. That's number one, right?
Yep, for sure, definitely. But and the second thing is just expanding the podcast. Like in a few weeks, I'm gonna actually try to set something up with face to face.
Oh, that'd be cool.
I'm gonna see how that works. You know what I mean? Like, because I know it's a person who records, so we're gonna try to set that up real quick.
That'd be dope. That'd be dope.
Anything else? Though?
No, man. I love what you're doing. So keep it up, man.
Thank you.
I watched some of your videos. I haven't been able to keep up. Like, I haven't watched Eddie's yet, but I saw the highlights, and I'm like, hey, I need to catch up on these.
Hey, he did mention you, though. He mentioned you.
Oh, yeah?
Definitely.
Probably all bad things. No, just kidding. Eddie's a good guy.
No, definitely. So for you, though, like, is there any advice you want to give out to people, like you said earlier, but, like, just about life in general?
I'd say like probably three things, like enjoy the process a little bit more than you already do. Like at the end of the day, like you'll be stuck with your memories more than anything. Make good contacts because that's what really matters. And just put in work, man. I feel like you can really do whatever you want as long as you like put your mind to it.
Yep, definitely.
You don't have to be a genius to do anything, you know?
Just put in that work, you know?
Keep on grinding, yeah.
Exactly. All right, guys. Thanks for watching this Javiiurena podcast. Ricardo Ramirez with me. We'll see you guys later.
Thank you, man. Yep. Later.